Welcome to the Physics Place, the place to learn about physics. And in this video, I'm going to talk about different kinds of radiation and their properties. In general, there are three different kinds of radiations produced by radioactive materials: alpha particles, beta particles, and gamma rays. The alpha particle consists of a helium-4 nucleus without the electrons. Beta particles consist of one electron, and gamma rays consist of a photon. You can compare this photon with light rays, but they are invisible to our eyes. From those three, the alpha particle is the largest and the heaviest, and it looks like this. So it has two protons and two neutrons with no electrons around it. The beta particle is a lot smaller and it looks like this. It's a small electron. And the photon, the gamma ray, is even smaller. It doesn't have any mass, it's just a photon, so it's an energy package which has a certain wavelength. Again, you can compare it with invisible light. There's also a fourth type of radiation called X-ray, which is compared to gamma rays. So all the properties of gamma rays are the same for X-rays. When radiation hits a material or goes through it, it can alter it. If it hits our body or goes through our body, it can alter things and it can be damaging to our bodies. It does this by ionizing the material, and I'm going to show you what it looks like. So here we have a material consisting of different atoms, and an alpha particle will go through it. This alpha particle has a positive charge of 2, and it would like to have 2 electrons. It doesn't have any on its own, but it can take some electrons away from other materials. So when it goes through this material, it can steal an electron from, for instance, this atom. So this electron will start following this alpha particle, and it will leave this atom. Then this will be ionized because it will have one electron too less. Therefore, alpha particles are strongly ionizing because they take away electrons easily. They're also very heavy and very large, so if they hit something, they can also destroy those atoms, which again, for our body, would not be so good. But because they're so big and heavy, they're also less penetrating than the other particles. If they hit something, they lose a lot of velocity, and if they don't have any velocity, they're not that dangerous anymore, and they're not able to ionize anymore. So alpha particles are strongly ionizing, but they are least penetrating of all radiation. Beta particles are negatively charged. So when they go through this material, they will not attract other electrons, so they cannot steal away electrons from these atoms. But there's two different things they can do. They can add themselves to this atom. So an electron, a beta particle, can add themselves, and then this one will have one electron too many and it will be ionized. The second thing they can do, they can knock off one of the existing electrons. So if this beta particle, this electron, will hit this one, then they both can fly away and this one will have one electron too less. So it will also be ionized. But chances are a lot less than with an alpha particle. Therefore, beta particles are moderately ionizing. They have a chance of hitting away an electron or adding themselves, but a lot of them will just go right through this and they will not ionize anything. Because they are a lot smaller and a lot lighter, they are moderately penetrating, so they are more penetrating than alpha particles. Now we will go to gamma rays. Gamma rays don't have any mass, they have just energy. With that energy, they can knock off electrons from an atom, but the chances are really small of this happening. Most of these gamma rays will go right through the material and nothing will happen. Because of that, the gamma rays are the least ionizing of the three, but they are the strongest penetrating. They will go right through any material, even walls, they can go right through. So gamma rays are least ionizing, but they are strongly penetrating. I will now have two example questions to check if you understood. Three different kinds of radiation go through some materials. As you can see, we have paper with a thickness of 1 mm, we have aluminium of a thickness of 2 mm, and we have lead with a thickness of 20 mm. And we have radiation A, B, and C. Determine which is an alpha particle, which is a beta particle, and which is a gamma ray. Try this now for yourself and pause the video. So we will start with the first one. The first one does not go through a piece of paper of 1 mm. The other two do. So this one is the least penetrating of the three, so this is an alpha particle. The next one will go through the paper, but is stopped by aluminium. The other one will go through aluminium, so this one, which is stopped, is a beta particle. It's more penetrating than the alpha particle, but it's not as penetrating as the last one. The last one is a gamma ray. As you can see, it goes through paper, it goes through aluminium, it even goes through lead, but the intensity is a little bit less, as you can see. But gamma rays are highly penetrating. We will now go to the next question. So we have three different kinds of radiation going through an electric field. So we have an electric field here, with a plus here and a minus there. We have here three kinds of radiations, and as you can see, they are bent. Some are deflected. Determine which is an alpha particle, which is a beta particle, and which is a gamma ray. So try that for yourself and pause the video. So if you look at the first one, it's deflected by the minus and it's attracted by the plus. So its charge is a minus, so it's a beta particle. This is an electron. The next one is not attracted or deflected by any of the charges, so it doesn't have a charge on its own, so it's a gamma ray. And the last one, it's deflected by a positive charge, it's attracted by a negative charge, so it has a positive charge, so it's an alpha particle. That's it. You should now know the three different kinds of radiation and their properties. If you found this video helpful, please let me know by liking, and of course don't forget to subscribe for more videos. Thanks for watching.